Hello student, this is Ashish Vegarwa from Electrical Department. Today we will learn basics of AC circuit in the subject AC circuit. So let's move to the content of this subject. In this topic we will start with the use of AC supply. What is the difference between AC and DC supply? How AC and DC generator will work? And we will learn how alternating EMF will generate. So let's start with the use of AC supply. So here you can see various domestic appliances like washing machine, table fan, grinder, mixer, refrigerator, air conditioner, tea maker, dishwasher, etc. which require AC motor. You might have wondered that why we are using AC motor instead of DC motor. Because AC motor having various advantages like compact in size, higher efficiency, lesser maintenance cost, etc. So here you can see one more device, that is microwave oven, which operates on the frequency. And as you know that DC supply not having any frequency, only AC supply having frequency. So we have to connect microwave oven with the frequency of AC supply. Here you can see one CFL lamp which operate on ionized inert gas. And as you know that ionization of inert gas only possible on AC supply. So also we have to connect CFL lamp with the AC supply. Here various electronic devices like television, home theater system, air conditioner, refrigerator, which may require AC or DC supply. In the air conditioner, we have to connect power supply with the AC supply and the control supply with the DC supply. So we have to use both the supply in this electronic devices. Here you can see various heating devices like electronic toaster, bread toaster, filament lamp, electric iron, etc., which operates on the RMS value of alternating current. So also we have to supply AC supply in heating devices. So ultimately we can say that 90% of our devices require AC supply. So that's why we are using AC supply in domestic or industrial houses. Let's see difference between AC and DC supply. Here you can see one DC source connected in series with the resistance. So current will flow from source to load. This is the direction of DC current. So current flows from this battery source to this resistance. This is the waveform of DC current, which indicated by straight line. Here one alternating source connected in series with the resistance. So this is the waveform of alternating current. Alternating current indicated by sine wave. So first difference is of polarity. This supply having polarity, which indicated by positive and negative sign. Whereas AC supply not having any polarity, which you can relate from the figure. Second difference is of direction. DC supply having a unidirectional current, whereas AC supply having bidirectional current. Third difference is of magnitude. DC voltage remain constant with the time, whereas AC voltage continuously vary with the time. Fourth difference is of frequency. So DC supply not having any frequency, whereas AC supply having frequency, which may be 50 or 60 Hz. So using transformer, we can step up or step down to AC voltage. Let's understand how DC generator will work. So here I am having figure which indicate two magnetic pole, N pole and S pole, which pole used to generate the magnetic flux. Inside having one conducting loop which made up of copper. This conducting loop connected with the commutator segment. This commutator made up of copper segment. So this commutator mounted on the shaft of armature. On the shaft of armature, we also have to connect these two brushes X and Y. This brush is used to collect the current from the commutator. This galvanometer used to detect the value of induced EMF. So let's understand how DC generator will work. Basically, DC generator works on the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So if we rotate the conducting loop inside the magnetic field, then EMF will induce in the conductor loop and this direction of current will flow. So current will flow from the A to B, B to C, C to D, D to this commutator Q. This Y brush will collect the current from the commutator and it will supply to the galvanometer. Thus, a galvanometer detects the value of induced EMF and current will come back to the point X, P and return to, come back to the original position A. So this is how current will flow. So ultimately we can say that in galvanometer direction of current remains same. So this is the DC EMF. Because if we rotate the conducting loop by 180 degrees, same time this commutator will interchange the position, it will also rotate by 180 degrees. We can say that direction of current in the galvanometer remains same. That's why we are calling this the DC generator. Let's understand how AC generator will work. Here also having two magnet, N pole and S pole. Inside having one conducting loop. This conducting loop connected with the two full rings. Difference between DC and AC generator is of these rings. DC generator required to half split ring, whereas AC generator required to full rings. So this way we can generate AC sine wave. So let's understand how AC generator ultimately works. So we can understand the working of AC generator in two parts, in positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So this generator also works on the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So during positive half cycle, EMF will induce in this loop. So direction of current will flow from A to B, B to C, C to D, D to this ring R2. Again, current will come back to the ring R1 plus B1 and come back to the point A. So this how it will generate one positive half cycle. After 180 degree of rotation, this AB part will interchange their position and it will come under influence of S pole. So current will reverse in the gravimeter. Let's understand working of negative half cycle. During negative half cycle, EMF also will induce. So if we rotate this conducting loop by 180 degree in a clockwise direction, then current will flow from this A to brush B1, this gravimeter G, come back to the brush B2, ring R2, point D, point C, point B. This will form one negative half cycle. So we can say that during positive half cycle, current will flow in one direction, and during negative half cycle, current will flow in reverse direction. So this way we can say that this is the AC EMF. Let's understand how we can generate alternating EMF sine wave using alternator. So here also having two magnetic pole, N pole and S pole. So magnetic flux line will coming out from N pole and reaches towards the S pole. Inside having one conducting loop, and this conducting loop connected with the series resistance, load resistance. So if we rotate this conducting loop in clockwise direction, and each rotation it will sequentially make angle with the magnetic field. That's the EMF will induce in this conducting loop. Let's understand the EMF equation for the alternator. So E is equal to Em into sin omega t, where Em is equal to maximum value and omega t is the angle between conducting loop and magnetic field in radian. So let's one by one put this each condition in this equation. So let's start with the 0 degree. If we put the 0 degree in this equation, we will get the alternating EMF is equal to 0 volt. If we put the 90 degree in this equation, we will get the alternating EMF is equal to 1 volt. If we put the 180 degree in this equation, we will get alternating EMF is equal to 0 volt. Again, if we put the 270 degree in this equation, we will get alternating EMF is equal to minus 1 volt. And again, if we put the 360 degree in this equation, we will get the alternating EMF is equal to 0 volt. We can say that during starting, it will remain 0. After 0 to 90 degree, it will try to increase. At 90 degree, it will become maximum. After 90 degree, again it will start to reduce. At 180 degree, it will become 0. After that, it will again try to increase in reverse direction. At 270 degree, it will become negative maximum. And 360 degree, again it will become 0. So we can say that this is a generate one positive half cycle and negative half cycle. This way, it will generate one full cycle. This is called a sine wave. Let me assign you some of the question. First question is that explain the application of AC supply. Second is that give the difference between AC and DC supply. And the third is that explain how we can generate AC sine wave using alternator. Thank you for watching.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.